Every Nation Southern Africa, great to be with you again. I want to say to you something really important. Now, the early church was described to be living stones. Living stones, and my Hebrew tour guide, when we went to Israel, explained to us that a stone that is left on the ground, that's not connected, they describe as a dead stone. But the stone that is built in is described as a living stone. And what is so interesting is that the early church in Acts chapter 2 devoted themselves to a number of things, the apostles' teaching, to prayer, to breaking of bread, and they devoted themselves to fellowship. So the question is, how do we do it? How do we do it in this crazy COVID season where social distancing is so important? My really good friend, Simon Lerofolo, pastor, leader, Every Nation Rose Bank, apostolic leader in Southern Africa, he's going to share with you some key tips and points of what they've done to keep the fellowship, to keep these stones alive, to devote themselves to fellowship in this season. Pastor Sai.
Hi, great leaders. It is my joy and honor to share with you today about pastoral ministry and care, especially in such a time as this, especially in times of COVID, in times of lockdown. We need to care for the flock. I'm reminded of Proverbs chapter 27, verse 23. In the NLT, it says, "Know the state of the flock and put your heart into caring for your herds." In the KJV, it says, be diligent to know the state of your flocks and attend to the herds, attend to the needs of the flock, attend to the needs of the people. I know that we may do pastoral ministry differently. We delegate, we get other leaders to help us, we get lay leaders to help us. But remember, the Bible exhorts us as leaders to be diligent in looking after God's people. In fact, when you read in Acts, it speaks about the very people that he bought with his own blood. So when COVID hit early last year, I'm grateful that we did not only focus on church online and also connect groups online. Those two were priority. We made sure that we get people to church online, we get people to connect groups online, but we also focused on calling people. So we as anchor pastors or services pastors, we held each other to account to this, that we're going to call a number of people during the course of the week. What we did is we will call during the week, and we started with our connect group leaders, making sure that they are cared for, making sure that we're checking up on them. We ask questions like this: how are you doing personally, emotionally, mentally, spiritually? We also ask them, are you connecting to church online? Are you connecting to your connect groups? Making sure that people are connected. We did find that some people were not connecting to church online, and it gave us an opportunity to encourage them, to pastorally nudge them to connecting and to also finding connect groups. So it is important for us as leaders to make sure that we care for the flock and we know the state of the flock. There's something that really, really helped us. It is a tool that was introduced by Pastor Roger based on the book called Four Disciplines of Execution. This tool, we call it 4DX, basically is selecting the people that you're going to call during the course of the week and holding each other accountable to whether we're calling those people or not. It is also a tool that is helping us to be intentional in reaching the lost. So we would also account to, are we reaching the lost? We will share testimonies of the people that we are reaching. So all the anchor pastors and services pastors, we had a meeting every week on Friday, just a 30-minute check-in where we shared about the people that we are calling and how those people are doing. It was so good to get this feedback. People in the church were saying, you guys do not only speak of family, you live family. So we don't want to just preach family, we also live family, we model family, and people were blown away by that. It became one of the highlights of the year, where as we've been calling people and making sure that they're doing well, we've been blown away by their faithfulness in attending church, being connected online, their faithfulness even in giving. What amazed me the most is beginning of this year, some of those guys started calling me back and saying, hey, what happened to those calls last year? I believe it's become culture now that they're calling me now as I continue to reach out to them. So, as I say, it became one of the highlights of the year for us. and we do well to practice what we preach. If we say we are family, we are community, let us reach out to the people of God. As I've mentioned on this course, we'll find out if people are in Connect group or they are joining to church online. As we find that some people were not in Connect groups, we will connect them to Connect groups. I want to share some testimonies and stories that will build your faith even in this time of lockdown. We've been blown away by how God has provided financially, that we've been doing well despite the fact that we are in such a tumultuous time. We were affected. We did see a drop in the income, but we have been stable, and that is by God's grace. I believe it also has something to do with the fact that we have a discipleship culture. Our people stayed connected. I believe it's also to do with the fact that we reached out to people. We showed that we care for them. One of the testimonies that has really touched my heart is how people have been praying for each other and standing with each other during this time. There was a testimony of a lady who is currently in hospital and fighting for her life. And last week, Saturday, we got a call that she was given 2 to 3 hours to live. And we rallied intercessors around. We rallied prayer around. One of our congregations here in Joburg, Every Nation Remsburg, they pulled together a Zoom prayer room where people could join in and pray for this lady. And this prayer ended up becoming a 24/7 prayer. And that Zoom room remains open for people who want to pray. For almost 3 days, we had people pressing in and praying. So we trust God to see God move. It was so amazing. On this room, Zoom room, we had other people from other churches joining. We had other unsaved people who are friends to this lady joining in the Zoom room. And they started asking, how can we be part of this church? How can we be part of community? Because they saw the love that was showered to this family. This family has experienced God's love. They have seen people come around them and showing them community, whether it's contributing financially or giving or helping them towards meals. It's been amazing. So we do well as leaders, as pastors, to connect and to know the state of the flock. God bless you.
Murutisa, thank you for that incredible testimony. And the story of Ayanda is such a great one of community coming together. And even that lady who came on the Zoom room and said she wants to join the church because of it, just so speaks of the need for people to be connected. Now, a great secular author that I've enjoyed, Malcolm Gladwell, he wrote a book called Outliers. Outliers is this mathematical term of something unusual, something off the beaten track. And at the start of his book, Outliers, he talks about the Rosetta mystery. Not the Rosetta Stone, but the Rosetta mystery, which was a town in upstate New York, which the sociologists and the healthcare people came across, and they said, there's something strange about this place, because here in this town, there's no cardiac problems, there's no suicide, there's no alcoholism, there's no drug addiction, there's no unemployment. For men over 65, the death rate is 50% lower. For everybody, the death rate was 35% lower. And they did a whole lot of research, and they said, is it the genetics? And they looked at this little Italian community, which was from a place called Rosetta Vallaforte in Italy, and it wasn't the genetics. They looked at the diet, and they weren't eating the classical Mediterranean diet. They were eating all the stuff that's not good for your heart. And it wasn't the geography. It wasn't something in the water, because they tested in the area. The conclusion of this particular research was, this was a guy called Dr. Wolf, was that the strength was that it was a church-centered community, that people lived in community with one another. The Harvard Business Study of health and longevity, it's the most thorough, the most complete, it's the longest lasting research project ever, said that the most important thing for our longevity is not diet and it's not exercise, but it's the depth of our relationship. And this is what the Rosetta people had experienced. This is what they were living. And so, brothers and sisters, Simon has mentioned to you some great ways of reaching out, phoning, connecting. We can't see each other face to face necessarily, but we can speak on Zoom. We can phone one another. I visited one of our Every Nation churches, the one in City Bowl recently, and all of their services were done with Zoom. No, it's not always possible depending on the size of the church, but they had Kaya and Connect beforehand and a whole lot of Connect afterwards, and they broke into Zoom rooms. And what it facilitated was beautiful fellowship. And so I want to remind you, we are meant to be living stones. We are meant to be connected. And the early church devoted themselves to fellowship. So I put before you both an encouragement and a challenge. The encouragement is that you do it. And the challenge is that you find the way, you find the appropriate way within your context, within your culture, within the constraints that you're living, to build people in as living stones, to help your people to devote themselves to fellowship, that we might experience what the Word of God has promised, just the blessing of His presence where two or three are gathered together. Let's be like those Italians in Rosetta who are healthy and strong. Let's be like those people in the Harvard study who prosper. Above all, let's be people of God. We live together in fellowship. We live together as living stones. I encourage you to find a way to do that in your local church. God bless you.